සෑමටම වාසනාවන්ත දවසක් වේවා. උපාධි පිරිනැමීම සඳහා 2020 වසරේ සාමාන්‍ය උපාධි ප්‍රදාන උත්සවය මෙම සතිවාරයේ දැන් නැවත ආරම්භ කරමු.
பட்டங்கள் வழங்குவதற்கென 2023 ஆண்டுக்கான பொது பட்டமளிப்பு வைபவத்தின் தற்போதைய அமர்வை மீள ஆரம்பித்து வைக்கின்றேன்.
I declare the current session of the year 2023 General Convocation is the reason for the conferment of degrees.
Very good morning to all. Ayubovan, Assalamu alaikum, Kalai Vanakkam. On behalf of the Venerable Chancellor, members of the Council, all staff members, I extend all of you a very warm welcome to the General Convocation 2023. My heartiest congratulations to graduates of the bachelor's degree programs of the University of Colombo. Today, we celebrate your achievement of a major milestone in your life. Your commitment to moving forward, even facing the challenges occurred by the economic crisis, political and social instability in Sri Lanka, is highly admirable. We at the University of Colombo are extremely proud of your achievements. At present, there are 10 faculties, 6 institutes, 1 campus, 1 school in the University of Colombo, comprising 77 specialized departments with over 43,000 learning partners. The university has produced numerous distinguished alumni who have gone on to achieve success in various fields, including scientists, academia, business, politics, and the arts. This year, 10 academic staff members of the University of Colombo recognized and ranked within the top 2% of scientists in the world. Today, the University of Colombo is number one university in Sri Lanka and within the top 1,000 best universities in the world, while having more than 14,000 free education students. Your education has been funded by your parents, taxpayers of the country, and the money generated by the University of Colombo. Education is a lifelong process, and obtaining a degree alone will not produce productive employees or responsible citizens. A degree with literacy, professionalism, and entrepreneurial skills will have more value today. The definition of modern literacy covers various aspects such as alternative language literacy, ICT literacy, digital literacy, financial literacy, technological literacy, scientific thinking, value creation, and networking abilities. Needless to say, you have indeed been fortunate to enter this prestigious university through a competitive process. I hope you have been transformed well during the past few years in the vibrant and stimulating learning environment provided by the University of Colombo. Hence, I encourage you to move forward and ensure that you become a well-rounded individual contributing to the country's development and success. I wish you all the very best. May you have a radiant future. Thank you. குலபதி சுவாமீந்திரன் வஹான்ச, கொழம்பு விஸ்வவித்யாலய பாலக சபாவ, சனாதன சபாவே நிர்தேசிய மத, தேசிய வைத்திய வித்யா பீட்டையே பீட்டாதிபதி விசின் உபஸ்திதேஹி சஹா அனுபஸ்திதேஹி இதிரிபத் கரு லபன பவதுன் வெத ஆயுர்வேத வைத்திய வேதி சஹா ஷல்யவேதி உபாத்திய சஹா யுனானி வைத்திய வேதி சஹா ஷல்யவேதி உபாத்திய பிரதானே கிரி மற்ற தீர்ணே கொட்டாத்தி பவ கௌரவேன் பிரகாசகர சிட்டிமி.
வணக்கத்துக்குரிய வேந்தர் அவர்களே, மூதவையின் விரப்பையின் பேரில் கொழும்பு பல்கலைக்கழக பேரவை உள்நாட்டு மருத்துவ பீடாதிபதியினால் சமர்ப்பிக்கப்படும் பெயர்களை உடையோருக்கு நேர்முகத்திலும் சமூகம் இல்லாமலும் ஆயுர்வேத வைத்தியமானியும் சத்திர சிகிச்சை மானியும் பட்டத்தினையும் மற்றும் யுனானி வைத்தியமானியும் சத்திர சிகிச்சை மானியும் பட்டத்தினையும் வழங்குவதற்கு தீர்மானித்துள்ளமே தங்களுக்கு கௌரவத்துடன் அறிய தருகின்றேன்.
Venerable Chancellor, I have the honor to announce that the Council of the University of Colombo, on the recommendation of the Senate, has resolved that the degree of Bachelor of Ayurveda Medicine and Surgery and the degree of Bachelor of Yunani Medicine and Surgery be conferred to those to be presented in person and in absentia by the Dean Faculty of Indigenous Medicine.
Abicorn AJMKP. Abigunwardana EADM. Abicorn EGNT. அபேவிக்ரம எஸ்டிடி. அமரதுங்க எம்ஹெச். அமுனுகம ஏஆர்எம்டிஎன். அனுராதா என்யூடி. அனுராங்கி பிஎல்ஐ. ஆராய்ச்சி டிஏஏடி. ஆராய்ச்சி கேஆர்ஏ. அத்தநாயக ஏஎம்பியு. அத்தநாயக AMWS. அவிஷ்க டிஏடி. பமுன்வாராச்சி WNTGDD. பண்டார KMTWR. பண்டார MRLM. பண்டார RMMS. Bandara RMMU. Bhagya RPS. Chanaka MBC. Chandima KPDD. Chandrasurya EGCM. Chatumini DLW. Chaturangani SDN. Dahanayaka RN. Dasanayaka DMPM. Dasuni LWS. Dayananda PAMB. Disilva DKLS. Disilva GLAH. Dineti D. DEP DEP WMM. Devapriya MR. Dharmasiri KWPN. Dharmatunga KGSP. Didulana GMA. Dilhara SVAR. Dilrukshi KH. Dilrukshi KMN. Dilrukshi KMS. Dilrukshi WD. Dilrukshi WH. Disanayaka DBVIJ. Disanayaka DMDS. Dunuvira DYS. Edirivira MM. Egodage ENK. Ekanayaka EMEGNI. Ekanayaka EMGL. ඉරිකෙවැල්ල ඩීආර්කේ. ෆජීලා එම්.අයි.එස්. ෆනෑන්ඩු පී.එස්.එන්. ෆනෑන්ඩු එස්.ඩී.එස්. ෆනෑන්ඩු එස්.එස්.කේ.එම්. ෆනෑන්ඩෝ ටී.කේ.එස්. ෆනෑන්ඩු ඩබ්ලිව්.ජී.ඒ.එස්. පොන්සේකා ඩී.වී.ජී. ගමගේ ඩී.ඩී.කේ. ගමගේ එච්.කේ. ගමගේ වී.ජී.එම්.එන්. ගන්ධහරි ඩී.වී.ජී. ගොඩගෙදර ජී.වී.ටී.ඩී. ගුණතිලක ජී.එල්.එස්.එස්. ගුණවර්ධන එච්.ඩී.එම්.එච්.පී. හංසමාලා ඩබ්ලිව්.එම්.එස්.පී. හරිස්චන්ද්‍ර එච්.එම්.ආර්.එස්. හර්ෂමාලි සී.එම්.ඊ. හර්ෂන් ඩබ්ලිව්.එස්. හෙලරාව එච්.එම්.බී.සී. හේරත් එච්.එම්.බී.එන්. හේරත් එච්.එම්.ඩී.බී.ජේ. හේරත් එච්.එම්.ආර්.එන්. හේරත් කේ.එච්.එම්.ඩී.එස්. හෙට්ටියාරච්චි එච්.ඒ.ඒ.එම්. හෙට්ටියාරච්චි වී.එල්. ඉරිපිටිය කේ.එස්. ඉදුමිනි ඩබ්ලිව්.ජී.එන්. ජයකොඩි ජේ.ඒ.බී.ටී. ජයලත් ජේ.පී.එන්.කේ. ජයලත් ජේ.ආර්.ඒ.යු. ජයමාලි ඩබ්ලිව්.එන්. ජයසිංහ PANTDM. Jayasinga AAI. Jayasinga DJMNK. Jayasinga JPDS. Jayasiri DTY. Jayathilake BMMS. Jayathunga KS. Jayavodhana JVGOPK. Dinasena MHDT. Kandanarachi NM. Kantiratna TWKA. Karunaratna TGCHMJ. Karunaratna KAG. Karunathilaka RHNH. Karunathilaka UG. Kaushalya WGGAP. Kabindi BYBI. Kabindya BAD. Kirti Singha SMMD. Kottagoda MT. Kumar HCD. Kumara MGTLP. Kumara MMP. Kumari RGAP. Kumari SMP. Lakmali KAD. Lakmali SMU. Lakmini DKAA. Lakshani KGI. Lakshani TAS. Lakshika GGR. Leelananda KKPC. Livera K.O. Lianarachi K.Y.V. Lianagama S.T. Lianagay H.N. Lianagay S.H.A.S. Madhubashini D.G.D.P. Madhubashini R.P.P. Madhubashini U.K.J.C. Madhubashini W.A.S. Madhumali G.D. Madhuranga B.V. Madhusarani N.C.T. Madhushan R.L.A.R. Madhushani H.M.S. Madhusanka A.M.G.P. Madhusika H.K.S. Madhusani G.H. Madhusani U.A.M. Madhuvanti H.H.C. Madhuvanti S.C.J. Malhari K.G.P. Mallikarachi S.R. Manohara M.G.R.K. Minushika B.D.K. Mindula H.P.S. Minipura Arachi P.G.C.M. Mudannayaka D.K. Nagoda N.H.N. Najla M.N.F. Nakandala D.S.K. Nanayakara R.M. Nanayakar S.B. Navodya M.A. Navasinghe N.M.S.K. Nerlampitiya AP. Nirmali WAH. Nishani PK. Nisanka SLK. Pandita Sekara DC. Patiraja GGIA. Patiratna SPST. Pavitra MMJ. Piris DHN. Piris GDM. Piris WPI. Pereira AGAM. Pereira AJH. Pereira KMH. Pereira KND. Pereira KWM. Pereira MIA. Pereira NPDNN. Piyathissa PGIW. Piyumali MSP. Prabodhi AAD. Prabodhini KI. Prabodhini WBMM. Prabodhini TAC. Prabuddhika WKJ. Prasadika GS. Prasanjani GT. Prasanna WRMAI. Premachandra LHALD. Premadas SD. Premathilaka MK RRD. Priyadarshani KGNC. Priyankara, PHSS. Rajanayaka, RMIGCSM. Rajapaksa, RMSL. Rajapaksa, SD. Ranatunga, RAGS. Ranatunga, RMSI. Ranaveera, KYH. Ranjimali, JVGD. Ransara, NPK. Rasangika, KMK. Ratnasinghe, GGNS. Ratnayake, EHI. Ratnayaka, WRMPK. Ravishan, LWA. Rimasa, HMF. Ruberu, TCS. Rupasinghe, GGDM. Rupasinghe, RAIL. Sachintani, IG. Samanmali, DLV. Samarakon, DMTN. Samaranayaka, H. Samaratna, BC. Samarasinghe, LSM. Sampath, SDLR. Sandaruan, SC. Sandaruvani, GAH. Sandaruvani, WANH. Sandunika, AGG. Sanjana, RPN. Sanjeevani, SHKK. Sarangi, UGS. Satarasinghe, SAR. Saumya RMK. Senarat KVDM. Senaratna MJP. Seniviratna DA. Seniviratna NVSUR. Sevandi BS. Shashikala BKU. Shilpa Swaraji TS. Shivantika GS. Shyanga PGK. Silmia NMF. Somapala PWCP. Soisa DDG. Subhasinga AKRS. Sugataratna AMMI. Supishpika AWDJ. Suranjit JDT. Suravira SADSN. Tamari WAP. Tarangani GVTN. Taruka DPD. Tarushika WGS. Tennakon TMPBB. BM. Tilakaratna TALT. Tilakaratna WAIA. Tulangani TGGKM. Udara MV. Umayandi MVI. Umayanga RLS. Ushantini R. Vimuktini PVS. Vitanagamage PSM. Olisadira HR. Vasana K A U R. Vatsala W I. Veerakkodi W A D N. Veerakon K M C G. Veeratna G G S M. Veerasekara SP. Veerasinga DIS. Veerasinga LSIK. Veerasinga NS. Veerasinga W M A D D. Veerasinga W M P C. Veerasurya B W M C C K. Vikramaratna K G M T. Vikramasinga BHLG. Vikramasinga KAT. Vikramasinga SK. Vikramatilaka DCK. Vijayanayaka DKDM. Vijayanayaka KAK. Vijayaratna HGDR. Vijayaratna TRWDRTG. Vijayasekara SR. Vijayasekara WMAA. Vijayasinga WL. Vijay Vikrama SPCG. Bachelor of Yunani Medicine and Surgery. Aisha AFF. Aisha MR. ABDHA MILF. Afra MAF. Anojita P. Akla MNF. Astra MF. Asma MIF. Astra HNF. Asamit AMM. Begum IMI. Dinuka GVS. Rangika WHH. Fawin JS. Fawin SS. Fatima MM. Fokhan AM. Fernando TNDS. Hamna SF. Hamsia MH. Hasna MBF. Hasana NF. Hasina AMF. Hilma MZI. Ifna MY. Dharatna ICNP. Jaisinga JMBS. Javodana AHMH. Dusla JF. Kalupana IH. Karim AAA. Kularatna MALC. Madhumal WAC. Malisha DP. Mathangavira AK. Mina MFF. Mina MNF. Islan JM. Mafiq ASC. Muhammadu F. Mustari MHFH. Najitha N. Nasreen NMA. Niranji JPPC. Nuha MNF. Nuza MNF. Faumia AMD. Pumanta PDL. Premaruban JNS. Razna AF. Razna MRF. Russia ACF. Rivasa MNF. Rihanna MMF. Rimaiza A. Rizna MMF. Rizna MR. Robina WF. Sadika SP. Saf FSM. Sala ISF. Sanjeevani GS. Sanujia JF. Sasna MHF. Shafna A. Safrinas MMF. Shalini P. Shamla MF. Shifaya MMF. Silmia MIF. Zuel MSM. Taski MJF. Zara ARF. Zari MZH. Zinat MSF. Thank you.
குலபதி வசீன் மாவத்து பெயர் யோஜி படத்தலானு தென் நம் குரநந்த பௌத்தன் வைத்து ஆயுர்வேத வைத்திய வேதி சகா சல்லி வேதி உபாதிய சகா யுனானி வைத்திய வேதி சகா சல்லி வேதி உபாதிய பிரதானிய கலபாவு சனாத்தகரம்.
வேந்தர் என்னும் தகைமையில் எனக்கு அளிக்கப்பட்டுள்ள அதிகாரத்தின்படி தற்பொழுது வாசிக்கப்பட்ட பெயர்களுடையோருக்கு ஆயுர்வேத வைத்தியமானியும் சத்திர சிகிச்சைமானியும் மற்றும் யுனானி வைத்தியமானியும் சத்திர சிகிச்சைமானியும் பட்டங்கள் வழங்கப்பட்டமையை உறுதிப்படுத்துகின்றேன்.
பை அத்தாரிட்டி வெஸ்டட் இன் மீ ஆஸ் தி சான்சலர் ஐ கேன் அப்பாயிண்ட் தோஸ் ஹூஸ் நேம் ஹேவ் பீன் ரெட் தி டிகிரி ஆஃப் பேச்சுலர் ஆஃப் ஆயுர்வேத மெடிசின் அண்ட் சர்ஜரி அண்ட் தி டிகிரி ஆஃப் பேச்சுலர் ஆஃப் யுனானி மெடிசின் அண்ட் சர்ஜரி.
Venerable Chancellor, I have the honor to present Mr. Asoka Hettigoda to deliver the convocation address in this session. Mr. Asoka Hettigoda, Chairman and Managing Director of the Hettigoda Group since 1995, he played a pivotal role in expanding the family business into global leader in Ayurveda and diversified industries. As the sole heir to the Hettigoda legacy, he combined innovation with a commitment to maintain the company's heritage of quality in indigenous medicine. In addition to his business acumen, Mr. Hettigoda is actively involved in Sri Lanka's academic and business sector, serving on Board of Management at the University of Sri Jayawardenapura, President of German Business Council, and Vice President of Hostels Association of Sri Lanka. He also contributes to national economic policy through his role on the Committee on National Trade Policy, recognized with numerous accolades, including Ayurveda Ratna Award conferred by the Houses of Parliament, United Kingdom. Mr. Hettigoda holds an MBA from the Postgraduate Institute of Management, and he further expertise in AI and business from the Northwestern University, United States of America. It is with great pleasure that I invite Mr. Asoka Hettigoda to deliver the convocation address.
Aibowan. Most Venerable Chancellor, Venerable members of the clergy, Vice Chancellor, Deans of Faculties, Registrar, Heads of Departments, Professors, Lecturers, Graduates, Ladies and Gentlemen. It is a great honor and a privilege to address the 2023 General Convocation of the Colombo University. I'm also proud to deliver today's convocation speech at the highest ranked university in the country. Further, I've had the honor of serving the Colombo University Council for the last 2 years. Hence, it's a special day for me. And I must thank the Vice Chancellor for giving me this opportunity. Let me first congratulate all those who are graduating today with Bachelors of Ayurveda Medicine and Surgery, Yunani Medicine and Surgery, Labor Education and Labor Management. You are embarking on a lifelong journey using all the skills, learning and experiences to create a better life for yourself and a better environment for all of us. You have shown the ability to withstand strong competition, societal pressures, to successfully complete your course of education. You have endured the most trying times of our lifetime. Petrol diesel lines that ran into kilometers and paid 4 to 5 times the normal price. Many hours of power cuts, at times 5 to 6 hours at a stretch. Fight for your gas cylinder, running from one hospital to another, looking for life-saving medicines for your loved ones, etc. It was a real horrendous, unforgettable experience, which you already have it under your belt. Consider, is that a positive experience? At least now you have experienced the rock bottom. This university has prepared you to face challenges, innovate, and get ahead of competition. This should be the first of many milestones that you will achieve in your life, and remember to make your alma mater proud in all of your future endeavors. Today I will discuss a topic that requires a lot of attention, not only as Sri Lankans, but also as members of the globalized environment. Role of technology in sustainable development is extremely important, as we need to feed, house, educate, and employ the world's growing population, while conserving Earth's basic life support systems and its biodiversity. Currently, we are facing huge challenges in our country in cost of healthcare, poverty reduction, and feeding the hungry. As Sri Lankan government is keen to improve on its Gini coefficient. However, according to Central Bank report for the year 2015, indicates rather a dismal picture. It has improved from 0.48 to 49 from 2009 to 2012. Income inequality is measured by the share of income where the richest 10% of households get 38%, middle 70% of the households get 57% share, and the poorest 20% households get a meager share of 4.5%. According to a study conducted by Learn Asia in 2024, Sri Lanka's poor has grown from 4 million to 7 million since 2019 to represent 31% of the population in 2023. It is as a result of the worst economic currency crisis that we faced in the history of Sri Lanka. This clearly indicates the income disparity of the island, and the type of development that has taken place for the last several years have not in any way assisted in reducing this gap. To resolve these critical issues, I believe new technologies can spur sustainable development and give a push to achieving equitable growth in Sri Lanka. Technology has become part and parcel of our lives today, making us demanding for newer technologies. Developed countries are blessed to experience new technologies, while due to globalization, poorer countries are not far behind, sometimes leapfrogging the natural introduction cycles. However, not all new technologies are accepted, as they now have to be sustainable and affordable. Hence, the primary criterion is technologies that promote sustainable, affordable development. What is sustainable development? The official agenda for sustainable development of the United Nations, adopted on 25th September 2015, outlines 17 sustainable development goals. Of the above list, I will focus on two items, namely good health and well-being, and affordable and clean energy. as I believe these two aspects are critical to Sri Lanka's equitable growth strategy. Good health and well-being ensure healthy lives, which promotes affordable well-being for all ages. Affordable and clean energy ensure access to affordable, reliable, sustainable, clean energy for all of us. I think we all know, experienced in the last 2 years, how important these two aspects. Needless to say, we all, as I said before, stood in line in hospitals, in pharmacies, to get essential medicines. We all stood in line to get our gas cylinders or petrol, diesel, or suffered hours in darkness. Good health and well-being. Having the highest life expectancy in the region, Sri Lankans have enjoyed better access to healthcare at state offerings as well as private care during the last few decades. However, the last 2 years, we all experienced something totally different to our predecessors. Denied access to good quality medicines and high standard of medicines. Life-saving medicines was substandard. We also know the recent reports. And the prices were unaffordable. We need to change this. Blessed with a traditional medicinal system, Ayurveda, which dates back to King Ravana's time, Sri Lankans have the option of using both allopathic and traditional medicines. As many in the audience are graduating with a Bachelor of Ayurveda and Unani Medicine, you have a significant role to play in reversing this trend and creating a better environment for all of us to live. With the growth of non-communicable diseases, chronic kidney disease, dengue, and other new age ailments, the need for new medicines have risen dramatically. Just to give a few examples how technologies are used to provide better healthcare. Biometric sensors are used in telecoms for remote applications to monitor various blood indications, heart indications. Today it is done remotely. Various handheld devices to be used by consumers to self-diagnose medical conditions within seconds and inform the nearest medical care partners accordingly. Through this application, a network of physicians will get to know the condition and direct the nearest medical institution of the patient's condition. Mobile health devices with wireless technology have enabled physicians and patients alike to check on healthcare processes on the go and have taken healthcare monitoring out of the lab and has made it part of our life. Use of modern technology and research to identify superfoods like Moringa and medicines from our heritage of Hela Vedakama to promote and to improve our health. South America is rolling out basic internet connectivity for health professionals in remote rural villages so that the doctors can now talk to leading medical professionals who can help without being there physically. They can even navigate and guide clinical scans over the internet real time and to help identify cause of the problems. Healthcare mobile apps help professionals make confident and efficient decisions in the moments of care. With the drug disease information readily available at your fingertips, caregivers not only save time, they can also improve patient safety. Studies consistently show the benefit of telehealth, especially in rural settings that do not have access to the same resources as metropolitan areas may have. Going on to the next part of my speech is the affordable and clean energy. With the high cost of fossil fuels, coupled with environmental degradation, renewable energy offers multifaceted benefits from its very nature that includes sustainability, climate safe future, augmenting economic growth, creating new jobs, and enhancing human welfare. We all experienced the value of green energy when, as a country, we could not afford to buy fossil fuels to run our power generation systems. And we enjoyed as many, many hours of darkness. Needless to say, the exorbitant electricity price increases that were forced on us, which totally disrupted our daily lives. With abundance of sunlight and wind energy sources spread throughout the country, there's even now a discussion of exporting green energy. This is the true potential of Sri Lanka. These green energies play a vital role in balancing the energy mix and allow small countries to weather the shocks of the world market. According to Michael Sapa, part of Policy Horizon Canada, the following list gives an idea of key technologies used or in the pipeline. Lithium-ion batteries, which rivals gasoline in energy density, offers five-fold increase compared to the traditional lithium-ion batteries. By using atmospheric oxygen, these batteries could extend the electric vehicle range dramatically. Fuel cells that require constant source of fuel and oxygen to run while producing electricity continuously. These technologies can be ideally used for stationary power generation or large passenger vehicles. We all have heard of tidal turbines, which are now in practice in some of the countries. As Sri Lanka is an island nation, we have tremendous potential in that. Space-based solar power stations to collect the solar power in space. They have a much higher collection rate than what is possible on Earth. It's also unaffected by the filtering effects of the atmospheric gases. Third generation biofuels involve genetic modifications of organisms to produce new fuels. Production of hydrogen from highly efficient algae is such an example. During my whole speech, I have emphasized the role of technology in sustainable development and some of the key aspects that affect the Sri Lanka's growth strategy. In addition, how these sustainable technologies can be pivotal in reducing poverty, hunger, and income disparity. If correct measures are implemented at the outset, the future, which you will be part of, will be greener, a better place to live, economically and socially. With these thoughts, you can play a key role in shaping Sri Lanka for the next millennia. Help Sri Lanka get out of the crisis we are currently facing. Improve sustainable development and equitable sharing of resources. Having been exposed to many challenges at the university and the commitment you have shown to complete your study is a clear indication that you are ready to face any challenge locally or internationally. Now it's time for you to take the bull by the horns, provide leadership, and be in the forefront of change for the better. I wish all the new graduates good luck in all of your future endeavors, and remember to make your alma mater and your country proud. Thank you.
උපකුලපති ස්වාමීන්ද්‍රයන් වහන්ස කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ පාලක සභාව සනාතන සභාවේ නිර්දේශය මත මානව සම්පත් අභිවර්ධන ආයතනයේ අධ්‍යක්ෂක විසින් උපස්ථිතෙහි සහ අනුපස්ථිතෙහි ඉදිරිපත් කරනු ලබන බෞතුන් වෙත ශ්‍රම අධ්‍යාපන වේදී උපාධිය සහ ශ්‍රම කළමනාකරණ වේදී උපාධිය ප්‍රදානය කිරීමට තීරණය කොට ඇති බව ගෞරවයෙන් ප්‍රකාශ කර සිටිමි.
வணக்கத்துக்குரிய வேந்தர் அவர்களே, மூதவையின் விருப்பையின் பேரில் கொழும்பு பல்கலைக்கழக பேரவை மனிதவள மேம்பாட்டு நிறுவன பணிப்பாளரினால் சமர்ப்பிக்கப்படும் பெயர்களை உடையோருக்கு நேர் சமூகத்திலும் சமூகம் இல்லாமலும் தொழிலாளர் கல்விமானி பட்டத்தினையும் தொழில் முகாமைத்துவமானி பட்டத்தினையும் வழங்குவதற்கு தீர்மானித்துள்ளமையை தங்களுக்கு கௌரவத்துடன் அறிய
தருகின்றேன். I have the honor to announce that the Council of the University of Colombo, on the recommendation of the Senate, has resolved that the degree of Bachelor of Labor Education and Bachelor of Labor Management be conferred on those to be presented in person and in absentia by the Director, Institute of Human Resource Advancement.
Good morning. Bachelor of Labor Education, Aloka Bandara, MABB. Dananjaya, HPDH. Fernando KSK, Fernando WTS, Kumar RMAIU, Kumar Singh THSH, Madhu MAV, Mallavarachi MAAA, Manoj WA, Mutukumari KS, Premalata A, Ratna Sekara RAHK, Sandarwan WL, Silva GBYB, Bachelor of Labor Management, Abheratna UDBP, Abhay Sekara MMS, Aponsu GRW, Aryadasa WANS, Atugala ANR, Ayeshmanta HAP, Bandara HTS, Bandara HRSP, Bandara PAM, Brahmananayaka BSOB. Brahmananayaka BSAJP. Chamira PAR. Chamika WAS. Chandana TB. Kure MDL. Dayananda MAS. Dilan AVL. Dilshan TADL. Disanayaka MS. Disanayaka SP. Fernando PIC. Fernando WAU. Fonseca WMSR. Francis MADP. Gunaratna KGB. Gunasekara HSC. Gunavardhana YMK. Guruge MDS. Guru Singha GK. Hemachandra LAS. Hemaratna ATS. Herat RPND. Ilankon IMSS. Indica WHN. Ishanka ML. Jayalat EADD. Jayasekara PCK. Jayasanta NPW. Jeevan PGDP. Kanchana OKS. කාර්යකරවන KPMGR කරුණාරත්න GAWD කොඩිතුවක්කු CK කුමාර ATNP කුමාර KPR කුමාර MACS කුමාරි AVWS ලියනගේ AN ලුසියන් MJ මදනායක MAPK මාධව HS මදුෂාන් JRM මහේෂිකා AAC මහේෂිකා LGD මුණසිංහ KP නාකන්දල LK නවරත්න URUH පෙරේරා ABH පෙරේරා WSNJ පියරත්න KYY ප්‍රබුද්ධිකා NNG ප්‍රසාද් WHGS පුෂ්පලතා T රාජපක්ෂ RMDPM රාජපක්ෂ RWVI ප්‍රණසිංහ PPK රංග JGS රත්නායක GTS රත්නායක RWIU රොෂානි HR රූපසිංහ RGAM සචින්තා THK Shamila K. R. Samanmali H. H. Samararachi S. T. D. Samarakon W. R. Samarasingha K. H. R. D. Sandamali W. A. D. H. Sanjaya R. A. U. Sanjeevani W. A. D. R. Saranga K. D. C. Senadira K. M. G. N. Sena Nayaka MS MLT Sena Nayaka NHLDK Senaviratna ESW MRVW CSK Sharan G. Shiromi W. N. Silva D. P. L. C. Silva S. M. M. Suryarachi YS Surya Bandara KTD Sumana Ratna PSS Taraka MHR Tatsarani PKT Tilakaratna JKDIK Udayangani WDH Upamali PGD Violet FR Vaninayaka WMIP Veerasingha WMIP Veeratunga HGB Veeravardhana PH Vikramasingha AMGS Vijaysingha WARL Vijay Singh WMPB විමලසේකර PCK Thank you.
කුලපති වශයෙන් මාවත පැවරියජි බලතලානුව දැන් නම් කරන ලද භෞතිකම් වෙත ශ්‍රම අධ්‍යාපන වේදී උපාධිය සහ ශ්‍රම කර්මනාකරණ වේදී උපාධිය ප්‍රදානය කළ බව සනාථ කරමි.
வேந்தர் என்னும் தகமையில் எனக்கு அளிக்கப்பட்டுள்ள அதிகாரத்தின்படி தற்பொழுது வாசிக்கப்பட்ட பெயர்களை உடையோருக்கு தொழிலாளர் கல்விமானி மற்றும் தொழிலாளர் முகாமத்துவமானி பட்டங்கள் வழங்கப்பட்டமையை
உறுதிப்படுத்துகின்றேன்.
குலபதி சுவாமீந்திரன் வஹான்ச கொழம்பு விஸ்வவித்யாலய பாலக சபாவ சனாதன சபாவே நிர்தேசிய மத மவிசிங் இதிரிபாத் கருண் லபன பவதுன் வெத ஓன் விசின் தாக்வன் லத குசலதா மத ரன்பதக்கம் சா தியாக பிரதானே கிரீமட்ட தீரணே கொட்ட ஏதி பவ கௌரவேன் பிரகாச கர சிட்டிமி.
வணக்கத்துக்குரிய வேந்தர் அவர்களே, மூதவையின் விதப்பிரையின் பேரில் கொழும்பு பல்கலைக்கழக பேரவை அதி உயர் திறமைகளை வெளிப்படுத்திய பின்வருவோருக்கு தங்கப் பதக்கங்களையும் பரிசில்களையும் வழங்குவதற்கு தீர்மானித்துள்ளமையை தங்களுக்கு கௌரவத்துடன் அறிய தருகின்றேன்.
வெனரபிள் சான்சலர், ஐ ஹவ் தி ஆனர் டு அனௌன்ஸ் தட் த கவுன்சில் ஆஃப் த யூனிவர்சிட்டி ஆஃப் கொலம்போ ஆன் த ரெக்கமெண்டேஷன் ஆஃப் த செனேட் ஹேஸ் ரிசால்வ் தட் த கோல்ட் மெடல்ஸ் அண்ட் ப்ரைசஸ் பி அவார்டட் to those to be present for having achieved the highest standards of excellence. Prizes and gold medals, Faculty of Indigenous Medicine, Bachelor of Ayurveda Medicine and Surgery. Professor Sarath Gamini Ranasingha Gold Medal, awarded jointly for PAMB தனந்த ஏஜிஜி சந்துனிகா. டாக்டர் ஜயந்த் எதிரிசிங்க அவார்ட் ஜாயிண்ட்லி அவார்டட் ஃபார் PAMB Dayananda, AGG Sandunika, Oriental Medical Science Fund Annual Prize, jointly awarded for PAMB Dayananda, AGG Sandunika. Dr. Pandit KGP Jayatilaka Memorial Gold Medal for excellent overall performance, AGG Sandunika. BMMS Jayatilaka. Professor Gunapala Amarasinghe Gold Medal for the best performance in Balaroga, jointly awarded LSM Samarasinghe. A.G.G. Sandunika. Senior Professor E.R.H.S. Sujita Idrispira Gold Medal for the best performance in subject Kaya Chikitsa, jointly awarded for P.A.M.B. Dayananda. A.G.G. Sandunika. University of Colombo Award for the Academic Excellence in Ayurveda Medicine and Surgery, Ms. A.G.G. Sandunika. Bachelor of Yunani Medicine and Surgery, Oriental Medical Science Fund Annual Prize, jointly awarded M.M. Fatima, A.R.F. Sahara, University of Colombo Award for Academic Excellence in Yunani Medicine and Surgery, non-qualified. Venerable Chancellor, I am now presenting a special gold medal starting from this year. In around 1970s, the University of Colombo, we started the labor education stream instrumental by great scholars like Dr. Kumari Jayawardena, Professor Osman Jayaratna, and many other University of Colombo distinguished academics. So it is our great pleasure from this year convocation, the University of Colombo Board of Management of IHRA, Senate of the University of Colombo, and Council of the University of Colombo unanimously decided to award Professor Osman Jayaratna and Dr. Kumari Jayawardena gold medal for overall outstanding performance in the general convocation year 2023. So it is our great pleasure to announce that great scholar Dr. Kumari Jayawardena is also present in this convocation ceremony. Let me to present Professor Osman Jayaratna and Dr. Kumari Jayawardena gold medal for overall outstanding performance, WMIB Vanninayaka. Thank you.
කොළඹ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයේ විද්‍යාත් විසුණී වසරේ සාමාන්‍ය උපාධි ප්‍රදාන උත්සවයේ මෙම සචිවාරය කල් ලබනු ලැබූ බව ප්‍රකාශ කරමි.
කොළඹ පල්කලකලක 2023 ஆண்டிற்கான பொது பட்டமளிப்பு வைபவத்தின் தற்போதைய அமர்வு இத்தால் பிற்போடப்படுகின்றது என்பதை நான் பிரணாபடுத்துகின்றேன்.
I now declare the current session of the year 2023 general convocation of the University of Colombo adjourned.